Hi, this is Jason Lewis, Midday's Technophile. Today we'll be reviewing the Asus ZenBook 14. When you think of a 14-inch laptop, you immediately imagine a smaller keyboard, a slower processor, and the possibility that this isn't the most practical size for a laptop. That's where you'll be wrong. The new Asus ZenBook 14 is designed to perfection. The machine comes with the latest gen Intel processors, including an i3, i5, and an i7 version. We tried out the i7 version. The specs are pretty decent overall. 16GB of RAM, 512 SSD, and a full HD screen. What this lacks though is a graphic card. As for ports, there are two USB-C Thunderbolt 3 ports on the left side, which double up as charging ports as well. There's also an HDMI port on the left. On the right side, there's a single USB 3 along with a microSD slot. The look of this machine is great. It's cute, it's small, and it's got this fancy circular scratch metal look around the Asus logo. I even like this grey color. When closed, this machine is just 1.39 centimeters thick. And this entire thing weighs a little over a kilo. The sound on the laptop is surprisingly good. It's loud and clear. The screen is also adequate. It has a decent viewing angle and it's bright as well. There's no touchscreen here, which is something that I don't miss because Windows is not a good interface for touchscreens. The webcam on the laptop is also good. I particularly like its integration with Windows, where it automatically unlocks as soon as it detects my face. What's amazing on this laptop is the battery life. You can get a solid 9 hours, if not more, from it. This is from a 65Wh rated battery. The thing that surprised me about the ZenBook was its keyboard. It is very efficient use of space. The keyboard feels large, and they have cleverly hidden the numpad and the touchpad. Press a button on the touchpad and the numpad comes to life. The keyboard is also very comfortable. I found it easy to use and adapted to its layout very quickly. There are a few caveats to owning this laptop. The first is that it is difficult to open and self-expand storage and RAM. The process is complicated and not something an inexperienced or even a person with limited experience can do at home. The second, there is no audio jack, which means you would either have to use the provider mini sound card to connect a headset or use Bluetooth headphones. That said, using Bluetooth on Windows is a little more annoying than it needs to be. The final caveat is that it lacks a LAN port, which is again rectified by yet another dongle. This time a USB 3.1. So if you're charging, using your headphones and LAN, you effectively have no remaining ports on this laptop, which sucks. Sure, you can go and buy another dongle to extend the Thunderbolt 3 port, but that's something additional that you need to cart along as well. For this size and form factor, there are a few sacrifices that needed to be made, and this is it. Would I still recommend this laptop? The answer would be a solid yes. Despite these shortcomings, the ZenBook 14 is a well-crafted piece of tech. I do realize that not everyone needs to be connected to a physical LAN, and not everyone is still into wired headphones, but it's nice to have an option here. Not to mention, this laptop also comes with a sleeve. Starting at ₹79,990, the ZenBook is definitely not a budget laptop. If you're looking at a solidly built workhorse at a nice portable size, this is the machine for you. This is your Technophile signing off.
Subscribe to Midday India. Get direct notifications on all our videos by clicking on the bell icon.